मॉर्निंग माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर माई SSB एक्सपीरियंस विद यू ऑल. आई एम सचिन उपाध्याय एंड रिसेंटली आई गॉट रिकमेंडेड फ्रॉम 18 SSB अलाहाबाद. इट वॉज माई थर्ड अटेम्प्ट एंड आई गॉट रिकमेंडेड फॉर NDA 145. सो टुडे आई विल बी शेयरिंग माई SSB एक्सपीरियंस विद यू. बिकॉज इट इज़ अ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस, सो टुडे आई विल बी शेयरिंग द पार्ट वन ऑफ द प्रोसेस विद यू, दैट इज द स्टेज वन एंड द साइक टेस्ट. So let us start with my experience. First of all, I'll tell you about my journey, what all I have seen in this SSB journey. So I have seen 3 attempts till now. First was my NDA 2019 attempt. That was my appearing attempt of class 12th. My second attempt was the TES 44 and my third attempt was NDA 1 2020. And in this I got recommended. And therefore I'll now share my journey with you. My SSBs were as follows. The first SSB was NDA 144, which was in 14 SSB Allahabad, 17 to 21st July 2020, and the result was I got conference out in that SSB. So in that SSB I was a fresher, and as a fresher I went there for the SSB, prepared, took coaching from a very known coaching academy, that is Balnai Academy, which is in Delhi. And after taking coaching I went for my SSB, and in my SSB I got conference out. So I'll discuss my SSBs one by one in a separate video. Today I'll be sharing my experience, so we will not waste time on my previous SSBs. Second SSB was TS 44 SSB, which was in 31 SSB Kapurthala. And it was during 31 October to 4th of November, and the result was also conference out. In this, our whole batch was washed out and we went home after that. So this was my whole experience, and my third SSB was my recommendation SSB. So I'll be sharing my experience about that. So as we all know, we all are SSB aspirants, or we all are defense aspirants. So we all know about the procedure. The day one is the stage one. And it consists of the OIR test, the PPDT test, and the stage 2 consists of various tasks that take place in 4 days. So I'll be sharing my experience of stage 1 today. So my stage 1 started with my OIR. First of all, I'll tell you my journey. So I started from my home in Roorkee to Allahabad in a train. And I reached Allahabad one day before my SSB, and I took a hotel room, and then I went for my SSB sharp 5:30 I went, and 6:30 was our reporting. So I reached there at 6, and 6:30 we were taken to the waiting shed number 2, and in the waiting shed number 2 we were told to keep our luggage and take all our documents and go to the Vikram Batra Hall. So we were taken to the Vikram Batra Hall, and after going to the Vikram Batra Hall, we were provided with our chest number, and my screening chest number was 35. My screening chest number was 35, and the reporting of the candidate was 47. There were 47 candidates who reported on that day on 4th of December. The reporting was there, and 47 candidates reported on that day. So we were taken to the Vikram Batra Hall, and we were given instructions, and after some times we were provided with the forms, and after filling all the forms and doing all the formalities, we were given the OIR test. So now I'll tell you about how my OIR test was. The OIR test was very good, and the difficulty level was also very medium. So OIR tests are not very difficult if you went prepared. So I went prepared, and the OIR test was very medium. I was able to answer all the questions in both the OIR tests. There are 2 OIR tests, as we all know, and the time depends on the difficulty of the OIR test. So we were given 24 minutes for both the tests. So my OIR test went well, and our OIR tests were taken, and we were made to settle in the Vikram Batra Hall. only, and another psychologist came and he instructed us about the PPNDT. So next test was the PPNDT, picture perception and discussion test. So picture perception and discussion test is very important for a screening process, and the most fearful thing is this only, the picture perception and description test, the PPNDT test. And candidates fear that how will they able to overcome this test, or how will they able to pass this test. So I'll share my experience with you. So my picture was, the PPDT picture in our batch was like this, almost like this. I found it on net and it was similar to this picture, and I saw some women there. In this picture there is only 1, 2, 3 and 4 women, but in our picture there were 5 to 6 women, but the scene was like this only, and the picture was this much blood. And if a person is going for SSB and is fresher, so he should know that the picture is this much blood, and the picture was this much blood. And I was able to analyze that the women are filling their pots, because I could easily make out that this is a pot and in her hand there is another pot, and she is a little girl or boy, and this is a boy or a girl who is filling the buckets from the well. This is a well. So I was analyzing the picture in the first 30 seconds that is given. So first 30 seconds were given to us to analyze the picture. So you have you all must have heard about this thing, that they instruct us that what should you do. You should analyze that what led to the situation, what is happening in the situation, and what will be the outcome of the situation. So what led to the situation? Hero identification. I identified my hero, that was this small boy. I have made it a boy. So this was my identification of hero. So I introduced the task, 3-4 lines of introduction I made. So what is happening? I made an introduction of what led to the situation. So second thing was what is happening in the situation. I easily made out that what is happening in the situation. It is happening that they are filling pots on the well. So by using resources are the well. 6 to 7 line I was able to write. Outcome of the story, I was able to easily write the outcome of the story as well. So this was my picture, and I would like to tell you about how what was my story. So my story was that Rahul was a small boy, small student, and during his summer holidays he went to his village, and he saw that his grandmother and other village women had to travel a long distance to fetch pure water. So what he did, that he with the help of the sarpanch and his family, he arranged a grouping or a gathering of all the villagers, and he discussed the problem that it is causing a lot of problems. So he, with the help of other villagers, constructed a small well type of thing in the village. And what he did, that he arranged 2 bullock carts and he went to the pure water source, and he fetched water in a hole and fill this well. By doing this, he was able to get a good amount of water, which lasted for about 2 to 3 days. He moreover guided the farmers that they should use high yielding variety seeds as well as drip irrigation, which would save water. So this was my story. And also he arranged water tanks by collecting money from the villagers as well. So this was my story, and I was able to narrate the story very well. And the group discussion was also very good. I was able to give 4 to 5 points in my group discussion as well. So this was my PPNDT experience. And in the PPNDT, one of the candidates also told that we should use test number 35 story as the group story, as he was very convinced from my story. And that's why I was able to get screened in this attempt. So I'll tell you about the next task. So this is the PPDT chart or PPDT page that we are given to write the story. First is your name, then chest number, roll number, batch number. Here you have to write the story, and here you have to describe the number of characters. So what I did, I mentioned in a circle this, and I wrote male, and I wrote 18, because I am 18 years old. So I wrote 18 here, and I gave the mood positive because it was a positive mood. And here I wrote that she is his mother or other villagers, and I mentioned the characters. I wrote the story that character's name was my name only, Sachin, to avoid confusion during the narration. So it is very important to have a name that do not cause confusion during the narration. So I wrote Sachin helps villagers to overcome the water crisis in the village. So this was my action. So I was able to easily write the story on in time and also my action properly. I was able to mention the circles and the mood of the character and the age of the character respectively in the box. So this is how my PPDT went. And after my PPDT experience, we were told to wait in the waiting shed area, and then we were called again, and our results were announced. And in those results, out of 47 candidates, only 20 were screened in. And from 20, there were about 11 repeaters, two screen out freshers, or screen out repeaters, we can say. In second round, the screen out repeaters becomes fresher. And there were about seven freshers. These were freshers, these number were screen out repeaters, and 11 were repeaters. So the amount of repeaters was very high. So 20 candidates were screened in, and I was given the chest number 14 after my PP and DT for the stage 2. So my stage 2 chest number was 14. So now I'll tell you about my psych experience. Psych is conducted in the day 2 of the SSB, and in the psych test, there are various tests that are conducted, including the TAT, VAT, SRT, and self-description. So one by one, I will tell you about how my experience was there in all these tests. So the first test is the TAT, but I'm telling about my VAT test first. The first is TAT, then it is VAT, then SRT, and then it is the self-description. So my VAT went very well, and I was able to write about 59 of my VAT. One VAT I left because I forgot to write in a hurry. So there was a confusion also with me during the VAT test. What I did, that there were two words, accommodation and arrangement. They both were very long words, so I misinterpreted them as the same word. So I left a blank in between. So there was a blank page or a blank slide in between. So I realized it after I reached the last word. So it was not far away from the last word because it was about the fourth last word that I left. So I cut it all the last words and wrote the sentences again because there is a 20-second time that is given to turn the page. So I quickly wrote all the sentences after cutting the sentence that I wrote with a straight line, and then I wrote the three sentences. After that, I moved on. So it was a bit confusion for me, but I was able to manage the situation. So the words were easy and difficult also. There were many negative words as well. So my advice to all the aspirants is that you should prepare the negative words first, and then you should go for the positive one, because if you are ready for the negative words, then you can make easier sentences with the positive words. And try to make sentences that you use in our daily life. Like if you are making dark, so what is dark? What do you make sense by dark? Darkness. So in a dark room, what removes darkness? So light removes darkness. Okay, so it is a simpler sentence. Light removes darkness. Okay, so you can write those sentences also. I'll make a separate video for the psych test also. And I was able to write 59 VAT. I told you 59 VAT I was able to write. Okay. The second test was my TAT, the thematic apperception test. So in this test, we all know that 11 pictures are shown and the 12th picture is a blank slide. My blank story was prepared prior to the SSB, so there was no problem in writing the blank slide or the blank story. The problem, the main challenge was writing the 11 stories. So I remember six stories from my 11 stories. I will tell you. You can take a screenshot of this. There were three people in a house, one with a knife, one fallen on the floor, other behind person with a knife. There was a person behind the person with a knife. So it was like a robbery scene. And the second was a boy walking in a deserted land. A cannon in the right hand bottom side. You must have seen this picture on net also. There is a boy whose footsteps are there on the deserted land and a cannon is in the right hand bottom side. So a boy walking out of the house, two elderly people crying seeing him go. So it's like he is going for a job or he is going for SSB also. So they are crying why he is going. So a boy shaking hand with a army personnel. This was a easier one. Two boys in a mountainous place. This can be a trekking trip. A boy with a farmer standing in the middle of farm. These pictures you have seen, and these were very common pictures. So I was able to write all my attached stories well and neatly, and I was able to complete my blank story also on time. So this was my TAT experience. SRT. So many candidates have a very large number of candidates have the confusion that how many SRT should we write in the reaction test. So situation reaction test generally determines on the quality you are writing. So if you are writing quality in 38 sentences that I wrote, 38 SRTs I wrote, so if you are giving quality in these sentences, then it is well enough for you to write. And if you are giving this much quality in 54 sentences, then it is also well and good. But it depends on your writing speed also. If your writing speed is high, you can write 40 to 45 SRTs in the time available. So I wrote 38 SRTs and I was able to complete the whole situation, and I was able to solve the whole situation in every SRT. So you should solve every single problem that is written on that SRT, and after that you should go to the next SRT. So I solved it like that and I was able to complete 38 SRTs on time. So the fourth test of the psych test is the self-description. So I had my self-description prepared in prior before my SSB. So SD is the simplest thing, but you have to maintain speed. So you should write every truth about yourself, whether it is good, whether it is bad. So don't over-highlight yourself, or do not over-glorify or overuse of negative sentences about you. So it should be avoided that you should over-glorifying yourself or overusing of negative sentences about you. So this was my SD experience, and SD was very simpler because I prepared it in prior. So many candidates prepare it in prior only. So this was my experience, friends, and my stage 1 and psych experience is over. And in my next video, I'll share my stage 2 experience, that is very important, that how as a repeater I was able to perform in the GTO task. So I have a Instagram page as well with the name of Defense Study Capsule, so you can follow. And if there is any problem or if there is any suggestion you want to give me, you can write in the comment section as well. So this was my experience. Till then, I always say thank you.